also only a 6-pounder. Food construction. Solid iron muzzle. My fist is about 3 inches wide, so it's probably 76mm. This is the kind of sword that their wife used. It's very heavily influenced by British cavalry swords. As you can see, it's got a curved blade that's good for cutting. It's got a tip on it, so it's okay for thrusting. It's got a basket hilt on it to protect the user's hand because pirates didn't wear armor. And the thing's got a thick blade that's good for cutting. This is a musket. And funnily enough, that lock that you're staring right at is a wheel lock mechanism, meaning that you had to turn a key to turn that wheel, and then it would have acted like a cigarette lighter once you pulled the trigger. Those things were very expensive, however, and they only had one shot. And if you lost the key, that whole gun would be useless, and I don't see a key with this one. Here we have grape shot. Basically, it turned a cannon into a massive single-shot shotgun that would have peppered the hull and killed with the crew. That is, these two things are shells. They contain gunpowder inside them to explode inside a ship. And those are some round shot. This, however, is not a cutlass. This is a small sword, a back sword. This is a small dueling weapon. It is not. And as you can see, it has a very small tip and a very light blade. This is not for cutting. This is for thrusting, depending on how stiff it is. That is most certainly a dirk. It's not designed as a primary. These two things are sidearms. Boarding axe, in case you get someone trying to throw ropes and hook your ship to pull it in. Very good for cutting fingers off. And this is how you get to your vessel. Shaft going into the area behind it, and that would have turned a reel, which would have pulled the rudder left or right. Compass. Scam. Apart from this piece of metal here, that's it. This